Now we're going to prove one that's so huge because it basically takes the glory for everything in all of literature, in all arguments, in all speeches, presentations of information, you name it. Essays, theses, the whole nine yards. Theses, whatever way you want to call it. And that is, all of these things start with an introduction and a conclusion. Who doesn't want to know first and foremost what this is about and ultimately what the conclusion is? They are the two most important parts of any piece of writing or any piece of presentation in the entire universe. And everyone knows that full well. They say, if I'm not interested in the introduction, chances are I won't be interested in the body. And if I'm not interested in the conclusion, chances are I won't be interested in the body. It's that simple, and it makes total and perfect sense in the mind of God. God himself does this in all of his presentation. Read the Bible, and you understand very, very clearly that the first and the last of everything is always the most important. Your introduction is far more important than your body, and your conclusion is far more important than your body, the middle section. That's the way it is in the mind of God. That's the way God does it. There's always bookends that are very, very strong. So we're going to solve these two kingpin words that are basically the summary of all literature and presentations of any kind of argument or information. The introduction and the conclusion are the most important things. Okay, well, we go to the root of these two words in their verb form. That's just the way it is. The first person singular verb form, which takes the root for all the rest. You say, I conclude, conclude. And then you have concluding, concluded, concludes. Well, it's I conclude. That's the first person verb of the word conclude. I conclude, or I am concluding. What is the root of that word? It's conclude, chopped off right at the D. You see that? That is the root. So that from that you get the branches conclude, concludes, concluding, concluded, conclude, you know, concluder, if you want to personalize that the person doing the concluding is a concluder. I think that could, that would be a fine, you know, word to invent if it doesn't exist. But it's all based on that stem, conclude. And the reason I know that's the way that it is in the mind of God is because once we, well, we do the math on conclude, you see it's gorgeously 72, and it perfectly matches what God does with the word introduce. Okay? You solve the first person singular in both of these action verbs, and then you take the whole tree. You take the whole tree, even the words conclusion and introduction, which are nouns, okay? They are nouns. They are not the first person verb form, which is the most important. That's where the root lies. That's where the juice lies. You solve that, you solve all the derivatives, okay? So, first the word conclude. And I start with the word conclude because it's even more important than the word introduce. Conclude equals 72 exactly, and now look at the letters. C-O-N, con, equals 32, and then the C-L-U-D is 40, and even better, the C and the U is 24-888, and then the L and the D is 16-88. So we've got three sets of letters in this root conclude, the divide by 8. Con, 32, and then the C-U and include are 24-888, and then the D-L is 16-88 to bring the grand total to 72, which is a triple of 888s. Amen. And so for taking the glory for that root, we take the glory for the word conclude, concludes, concluding, concluder, concluded. Now we're going to do the same with introduce. Okay, the root of the words introduce, introduces, introducing, and introduction is, of course, exact same as we did with conclude, introduce, chopped off right at the C. Shoom, right at the C. That, those are the common letters to all the branches. That is the root of the tree, okay? We solve the root, first person root. And that root is introduce. Introduce, chopped off right at the C. This one is 8 letters, conclude with 7. Both are glorious. Both serve the number 8 ultimately. Introduce adds perfectly to 104, but just look at how glorious the individual letters are. It's so overwhelmingly loaded with 8, it's not even funny on a letter-by-letter basis. First, we have the I pairs with the O. That's 24 triple 8. Then we have the N pair with the R. That's 32 quadruple 8. Then we have the T pair with the D. That's 24 triple 8. And then we have the final U and the C side by side. That's 24 triple 8. So all told, we have 24 triple 8 plus 24 triple 8 plus 24 triple 8 plus 32 quadruple 8 in pairs of letters. That's how strong this word is. In 4 pairs of letters that make 8 letters in total, we get the numbers 24, 24, 24, and 32. I ask you, could a single word possibly be screaming out the number 8 on a letter-by-letter basis any more strongly than this word introduce? Not a chance in the universe. So, quickly and definitively here, who takes the glory for every single introduction of every single article, publication, book, essay, research project, presentation, conversation, you name it? Anything with an introduction. This includes you greeting someone on the street, introducing someone at a party, introducing your class to a piece of information. Introducing, you know, it's one of the favorite words in marketing. Introducing the all new, you know, it's like the first word out of everyone's mouth. Introduce. Why? Because it's the most mathematically brilliant word in the universe for the glory of the owner of the universe, Jesus equals 8 of 8. It literally is so astonishingly glorious, it's stupefying. Introduce. As you stare at it longer, you're just like, how is this possible? How can this be? Well, it has to be, because Jesus insists on everything being the maximal glory for himself. Okay? Mathematically. That's the way he's ordained it, using numbers. So, again, introduce. In 8 letters exactly, we get 24 triple 8 for the I and the O, 32 quadruple 8 for the N and the R, 24 quadruple 8 for the T and the D, and then 24 quadruple 8 for the U and the C. In 4 pairs of 2, we get 4 gorgeous numbers that are just screaming out the number 8 in the highest level possible, all knit together like a triple braided cord to make the grand total of 104. That's the first 3 digital factor 8 numbers divided by 8 perfectly. So now, when we pair the root of introduce with the root of conclude, we are pairing 104 with 72, both dividing by 8 brilliantly. And then together, that total becomes exactly 176, which is just over the top. It's 8 times 22. All of those are 7n plus 1 numbers. 8 is 7n plus 1. 22 is 7n plus 1. 106, 76 is 7n plus 1. That's the number of verses in the Psalm of God's Word, Psalm 119. The Psalm about how God's Word is the king of everything, which is basically what we are solving here. God loves words more than anything. He even says so in the Bible. He says, I have magnified my word above all my name. Right out of God's mouth, he says, I love using words more than anything to glorify myself. He's the king of words, and he's the king of numbers. And he has designed numbers to be words themselves, so that he is the king of efficiency. So not only is he speaking words, he's also speaking numbers simultaneously. While he's speaking numbers simultaneously with his words, he's glorifying himself both semantically and mathematically. Such is the brilliance of God. It has to be that way. He's the king of efficiency. He's too intelligent to do anything less than that. Only God can speak mathematically gloriously while speaking semantically gloriously. There is no man on earth that is that intelligent to do that, to make sure that all of his words are perfectly mathematically gorgeous while he is dictating his message. Only God is intelligent enough for that. And that's why God has ordained his languages to be that way. So he says, look at how good I am. Look at how glorious I am. Not only am I talking to you, but I'm also making sure I'm bringing mathematical glory to myself while I'm speaking in real time. That's the God we serve. So, this is such a huge one, and I'm spending a lot of time on this one because it is so big. It's so big These are two huge gems. These are two of the biggest gems in the mind of God. Introduction and conclusion. The first person verb, introduce and then conclude. What do you do in any presentation that you give to someone else? And this could be a media presentation at the office, you know, with the company. This could be a simple introduction of yourself to someone you've never met. This could be explaining to someone how to do something. First, you start off by introducing the subject, and then ultimately you conclude by saying, what's the most important part of what I've just said? In any thesis, in any article, in any journalism, everyone knows. It is drilled into everyone's head. Make sure you have a good introduction, and make sure you wrap it up with a good conclusion. And every single thesis, and by the way, we're going to throw the thesis gem in there. Thesis equals 80 exactly. Okay? Thesis equals 80 bang on the nose by Divine Orange. That has a 24-888 at the dead center with a 56 flanking it on either side. 80 perfectly in grand total. The thesis is the topic of the essay. Everyone knows that the thesis is the most important part of the paper. They really emphasize that in any kind of education. It says, take a lot of time to craft your thesis statement, they call it. Well, it's a thesis. Thesis equals 80. So do you see how Jesus makes sure he takes the glory for the best of everything? Because thesis equals 80 exactly. So Jesus equals 80 today takes the glory for every single thesis that has ever been put together in the history of the universe and that ever will get put together. And as we speak right now, there's several million of them being worked on in the minds of men. Students, grad students, you name it, musicians, you know. But this word introduction and this word introduce and this word conclude that we have just solved mathematically is so big. It's not even funny because it applies to everything in the entire universe. Think of all the speeches that anyone makes in Parliament, President, Prime Minister, Monarch, whatever. When they open their mouth to speak, they start off with an introduction, and then hopefully they come to some kind of conclusion at the end. And every single essay and paper, the intro and the conclusion are the most important part. So we have just taken the glory for every single introduction and every single conclusion that has ever been written, spoken, performed on planet Earth, and that ever will be performed. That's just the way that it is. We solve the root of the word conclude. And we solve the root of the word introduce. And that's the way you must do it in the mind of God. Okay? Oh, praise God. Praise God. And yes, we solve the word period, which is typically the end of every single conclusion. And introduction. And thesis statement. Period boils down to 8 exactly. Never forget that. When I say the word period, just think to yourself, 8. There he goes, saying 8s again. Period. 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 8. 8, 8. That's what I'm saying in the mind of God. So, no one writes a thesis. No one writes an introduction. No one writes a conclusion. No one places a period on any paper without mathematically glorifying the owner of the universe, Jesus equals 8. And of course, paper equals 56. So, no one does anything on this planet without glorifying Jesus mathematically. And that's the way he has ordained it to be. That's the way he has chosen to make sure he gets the glory for everything, using numbers. And specifically, the words and the very letters that people speak are numbers. That's how he's chosen to do it. That's how he's chosen to do it. So that everyone is glorifying him whether they know it or not. He's just like, it got you there, got you there. Oh, got you there. You thought you could do something without glorifying me, but you were wrong. Got you there. It all adds up perfectly for myself. So, glory to Jesus Christ for these revelations. Let's just jump on to a bunch of other words here.